Hi guys, welcome to Standard Chart. So this video is all about Nifty analysis as well as the stocks which I've asked you guys to ask for any query. So those all I have already shared the chart. So I'll just tell you guys what needs to be done with respect to the chart. So Nifty is still not in a clear zone as per to me. It is still, it is in the channel only. But what I also could see is I said that the Nifty might take support around this zone or come towards 13,500 to 13,600. Okay, but let's see how this is going to play. But for me, what I would say is if Nifty is again crossing this zone, then it will be Nifty will not go towards 14,000 to 13,300 or 13,500. So this is what we also saw in the case of 2008 as well as to 2009. So let me take those charts. So Nifty taken a support at this zone, and then it made a high clear, breaking the swing high. So if you guys see, let me draw it clearly. High, low, lower high, lower low, lower high, lower low, lower high, lower low. And after that, this was the lower high breaking zone. So this was a new high which is formed. Clear? So and after that, Nifty did not break this low. And once after started breaking this high again, it started moving up. So the similar way, I'm expecting this to happen in the daily chart. So if you guys see over here, let me remove all the drawings. Clear? So whatever used to happen in the daily chart now, actually it happened in the monthly chart in the 2008 to 2009 crisis. So if you guys see over here, what has happened over here is, so this was a low and high which has formed, and after that lower high, lower low, lower high, lower low form. And this is the zone where the low or lower high has been broken. And if suppose this low is held, then if suppose Nifty is again breaking this particular high zone, then I'm expecting another bull run to start. So this is what my expectation, and that is why I gave an updated view on the Telegram channel. So now let's move on to the stocks, what I wanted to discuss. So I'm telling and repeating it again. So whatever happened in the monthly chart in the 2008 and 2009 crisis is happening in the daily chart. So there, if you guys see, the once a lower high is broken, a new high is formed. After that, the lower low is not broken. Only higher low is formed and then started to continue the bull trend. So the same thing can happen over here. So this is what my understanding, and that is why I corrected that. Okay, maybe this low will not be broken. Clear? So now let us see what all the stocks we have discussed. So it was Zeal stock. Zee International. Okay, so this is what the stock is. Okay, so what is my expectation is like? If you guys see this chart very clearly, after forming a base over here, it started taking support at this breakout zone. Clear? So Zeal is taking support at this breakout zone. And even though after making a high, now it is forming a wedge pattern. So as per this wedge pattern, if this low of 170 is not going to get broken, then we can see some good upside, and that upside can be at least it can take to break this zone also. 260 can also be broken. So Zeal is something which should not break 170 zone. So that is what the stop loss I have given. So if anyone is holding or wanted to add, kindly add with a stop loss of 170. So once 170 is broken on a weekly basis, then try to exit the stock. Suppose if it is broken, again, it can go to 160 and then come to 140 also. All those odd levels are there. So I would say that if 170 is broken, try to exit the stock. So this is what I understood with Z. And the next stock, what was asked, is Tata Elxsi. So this stock, if you guys see, it has already moved a lot. So from this particular zone, so let me take it to a monthly chart. So if you guys see over here, this was the complete consolidation zone. And after the consolidation, it took a 2 times rest, retest. And after the retest, if you guys notice again, so this is a double bottom zone which has formed. Clear? This is a double bottom zone which has formed. So as per this, what we can expect is from 1480 to 498, nearly 1000 points move is expected. So the expected target was around 2,480 to 400. This is what the expected target, but it has also stretched a bit again. So my expectation is like it has to come and retest this zone and then only it has to move up. So I will not Tata Elxsi for some days or some months. If you guys see, this has taken a move like this, not in a single way. Sorry, it has moved in a single way like this. Okay, so anything might happen here now. So this can, after making a high over here, this can also make a bottom also. Like it can come again for a retest also. So we need to wait carefully on Tata Elxsi. So I would avoid this Tata Elxsi for now. Then Escorts, I would say it is also looking like Z and it is in a support zone. So what I would say is like I already marked some drawings over here. So let me remove all these. So as per my analysis, the Tata Elxsi also is in a good support zone. So I would say 1,000 and 1,100 below, it should not break. So it has taken some support. So if it is like still wanted to stretch a bit, then it can come till 1,080 zones also, but it is at a good zone to add. Add cautiously and add with the same strict TESL whatever I have given. So not to blame me for any of your profits and loss. It is strict. I'm just sharing my view. It can be wrong at any time. So a good support is seen over here. So which is coming around 1,000. But what I would also say is like here is also good support where market was trying to revolve at this zone for a longer time. So below 1,000, I am not expecting it to go. So this is what my expectation in Escorts. So Jindal Steel stock, Jindal Steel, Tata Steel, JSW Steel, all has moved a lot. I won't touch this stock for some time. These are cyclical stocks, and if you guys see over here, from 2013 to 2021, it has not moved anywhere. So the zone to add was here once after giving a breakout. It can still go to 65, 655 to 700, not an issue. But where will you be able to take a entry? If you are going to take an entry, the stop loss will be here. It is around nearly like 50-50. 50% stop loss. The stock is around 485 and the stop loss is around 296, around like 50% stop loss. And if you guys also notice, this will be good if it is coming for a retest and then going up. Okay, this will be good if it is coming for a retest. After a breakout, a recent retest is what always I expect. So Jindal Steel, I would say do not touch it for now. And Minda Corporation, which is something like a bit confusing chart, I would say. So I would see that it was near the support zone. See, this particular zone was acting as support and resistance. And again, the same, this particular zone was acting as support and resistance. So this is again like formed over here. Formed over here. And after that, this again formed over here. So it is roaming around the support zones. Okay, so that is why I gave the stop loss to be 80, 82 or 80 below that on a weekly closing basis. It's better to exit. But it is still in the upper side only. It can go again upside only. So we have to wait. If it is breaking good with volume at around 120 zone, then it can still move up. But if anyone is holding, hold with ATSL. If anyone wants to try new, do not try it. I would say do not try it. And then the next stock is Adani Enterprise. I would not touch Adani stocks for now, okay? Because see, this, I basically what I believe is like a stock which comes out of a good consolidation. I always respect for a pullback, but see over here, I could not see a good pullback at all. So assume if you are considering this is the good consolidation zone, then also a pullback has happened. But this is a parabolic rise, and this can ultimately form a downside move also. So let me show you guys some stock over here. See, this is one stock. Okay, see how the stock has risen. From here, it went up to like this and then started moving down. So that is why I avoid Adani Enterprises. It has moved a lot and I don't believe in this stock. This stock can come for a pullback. See, assume where it will come for a pullback. It will come for a pullback at the support zone. I could not find up any proper support zone. Maybe this zone, but it has hit once and taken back. If it is hitting again, it can break. And after that, this zone where it has never tried as a support, and this zone will be the next point of zone. And ultimately, the support zone will come over here. So I don't want to touch Adani Enterprises. It can go still up. It may go, but I don't want to touch Adani Enterprises. And then the next stock is Concur. Concur is coming, is still trading inside the range. If you guys see over here, this is still inside a range. Clear? And I would say it is better to wait. I could see an accumulation pattern over here. If it is able to give a good breakout on, with a good volume, then what is expected is like any breakout and retest can take it to further upper levels. If you guys you see, there is good volume also seen. So I would say it is better to wait in this, better to wait and have this in watch list. Once a good breakout is in, then that is opportunity to go long and conquer. Then Cipla, Cipla is also some same view like Zeal and Escorts. So it is like a breakout and a retest is happening. So a good retest can around 860 levels is what it can go upside. So I'm not expecting anything below 860. So let us see what will happen in Cipla. And then Z, I have already shared Jubilant Foodworks. So I'm a bit bearish on this stock. I'm not that bullish. So my expectation is like, see, this is forming an head and shoulders pattern. So if it is a good head and shoulders pattern, then ultimately 2500 levels will be broken. So if it is breaking, then I would say worst things can happen in Jubilant Foodworks. So what I would say is like, let me draw and show you guys. So head and shoulders pattern, right? So this is one shoulder. This is head and this is shoulder. So this is what my expectation in Jubilant. So if it is breaking this trend line and then 2500, some zone of reaction will happen and after that it can break. So ultimately 2000 can come in Jubilant Food. So I'm bearish on Jubilant Foodworks. So HDFC Life is what I've taken in the insurance company. So again, I'm bearish on this as well. I'm expecting some 580 levels to reach. So that is highly possible in HDFC Life. Yes, it is bearish, not, see, it, though the stock is like, so this stock has come out of a good inverse head and shoulders and then a breakout is seen, but still it is like roaming only, not able to give, see, the breakout has happened around 20 November and still it is roaming more than 6 months. So I'm expecting it to still come down, take some support over this zone and then go back. So at HDFC Life, I'm a bit bearish because if you guys see, this is also forming a head and shoulders pattern. Okay, so let me show that as well. So this is also forming a head and shoulders pattern. So if this is valid one, then what could happen is like it can again go down. So that is what my 580 is the level what I'm expecting. So it is highly possible. So let us see what is happening in HDFC Life. And yes, futures or intraday, whatever you do, whether it is a BTST or whatever, the intraday futures will not be counted as a normal equity brokerage. Futures brokerage will be around 350 to 360 rupees. That will be the brokerage charge. So Tata Steel, it is also as more, it is a cyclical stock. So it has already moved a bit. Okay, a huge movement is seen in Tata Steel. Clear? Okay, and I just mark my theory. My theory is like breakout is happening. Okay, good, awesome. And after a breakout, you can take some few quantities, but a retest is was, I always wait and watch. So I am expecting some retest to happen. Okay, though it has moved a long way, I expect a retest to happen in Tata Steel. And then Asian Paints. Asian Paints, I am bearish on Asian Paints. Again, a good move has already been seen. See, a good consolidation, good move is already seen. So my expectation is like, this is where the zone, the stock was reacting a long time in a monthly chart. If you guys see from October 19 to August 20, it was roaming over here. So a good retest can come to 2000 or 1800 zones for Asian Paints. So I'm bearish on Asian Paints. And then the next chart is IEX. So this chart, this chart gave a breakout, roamed for some time and then started moving up. It has also got extended. I would say not to touch a stock, any fresh entry I won't prefer in IEX. A good fundamental monopoly company, but right now, if you guys ask me, can I enter? I would say no. It has already had moved. I would not ask anyone to enter. No. So that is what my expectation Indian IEX. So then when that would be a question for many people. So I would say that let it come down, let it rest, let us consolidate, let it form a base again, and then we will get an opportunity to move up. Clear. So let it form a base. So that is what my expectation in IEX. And then Naukri also has to come down a bit. So I would say this is the SL for now. It should not go below 4,000 levels. So let's see what is going to happen in IEX. See, a good breakout, retest for some time, a good pullback, and then crash. After that, moving, and then a good pullback is seen. So any base should form a base. If it is trying to form a good base, then it will be a good time to accumulate. Otherwise, it is better to avoid. And then S-Bank is sort of hero or zero stock. I don't prefer S-Bank a lot because you see, this is one sort of a parabolic action. Went straight away up, straight away down. And now at its like lower value only, we will not be able to say whether we can accumulate or not. But if again this last low of 5.65 is getting broken, then there is no hope in S-Bank. But if anyone wants to try, just give a try, like hero or zero. Okay, just put some 1,000 rupees or 500 rupees and see whether your luck comes out. That is what I can say. But nothing more to say in S-Bank. And then Kalpat or Power. Okay, so this is a good, good accumulation has been seen. So if you guys see, initially this was a breakout, a consolidation zone, gave a breakout, consolidated, moved up, and now this is again a consolidation zone. So this is what, so I would say, let's wait. I'm not expecting it to go below 253 or 253 to 300 zone. So I'm not expecting it to go below that. So any pullback around 300 will be a good opportunity to go buy. So that is what is expected in Kolkata. And then SBIN, I'm a bit bearish on this stock, but what I would say is like this particular stock is still inside a consolidation zone only. I'm not much impressed with the chart or no. It is still in the consolidation zone only. So any pullback towards 300 is again a good buying zone for it to move up. So it can perform, but it needs some time, I think. So it has to accumulate. The volumes are getting accumulated good. Volume is, the accumulation is good. So I would say like 290 to 300 is a zone for it to get accumulated, and then it can move upside. So that is what my expectation in State Bank of India. Clear? And then Dabur, I think all the FMCG stocks are at a bit worrying state only, because Dabur is also formation of pattern is showing a lot of bearishness. So I would say any fall below this zone, 497 zone, can take it to worst case of 400 also. So Dabur is very bearish. So I would say not to prefer entry. But if anyone is holding, try to keep like this is as your SL. So that would be your point where you have to be very careful. So 495 to 500 is a zone for worry. And same Hindustan Unilever as well. Okay, it is also bearish, and I'm expecting it also to fall down. So again, if anyone wants to hold, like holding, keep 2,300 as the SL. In worst case, it can come around, come below 1,700 also. So Hindustan Unilever. So and then coming for Page Industries. So this is the Page Industries chart. So Page Industries, it is at some sort of resistance zone, trying to accumulate or trying to get some power. So what I would say is like, let it consolidate for some time. I would say it can go up, like give some 10% move and then come down, and then only it is expected to move upside. So I would say this zone should not get broken. So that is what my view in. So let it be like here, A, B, C, D, E, or A, C. So my expectation is like, let it come to this zone. 2,800 to 2,900 is a zone to watch out. I would expect like 2,500 will be the zone to watch out. So this zone is highly possible. So this is what I wanted to say. Page Industries and more often lab. I got this stock for nearly 100%. I got a bagger on this stock, but ultimately what happened was like it gave a news. Some news came around this stock, and that is why I exited in the stock. But if you guys see, it was a good base has formed. If nearly some 10 to 20 years of base has been formed and it has given a breakout. Any retest and coming towards 50 zone or 45 zone is again a good opportunity to move upside. So that is what I see in Morapin Labs. Just focus on the quarterly results. If the quarterly results are coming good and if the quarterly results are performing, then any pullback towards the 45 to 50 zone is good opportunity for accumulating this stock. But for now, as it is in the levels of 72, it has to come down. It has given a breakout. I would respect like a pullback to come. So that pullback is the opportunity to go long in Morapin Labs. And then Atul Auto, I'm not taking it because it came at 7.1, but let me also share that analysis. I have not checked that stock. Okay. So first, this stock, guys, just watch out. I'll just tell you how I analyze the chart so that you guys can also watch. Like, okay, this is the way of, you guys can correct me or anything you can do. Okay. So firstly, I go from the longer trend frame. Okay. So this is a monthly time frame, and as per the monthly time frame chart, this stock is at just formed a base. Okay, just formed a base and not a clear base has been seen. So as per monthly chart, it is still in a downside and downwards only. And in a weekly chart also, it is downwards. And if you guys see, good volumes are seen. Okay, good volumes are seen. So I would wait for this stock. Clear. Okay. Good opportunity is also seen. Okay. Good opportunity is seen. So I would say this is a low which it should not break. 142.60. This low should not break. If this low is not breaking, then we can see an upside in Atul Auto. Yeah. So this is all the overall view or analysis what I've done in the stocks which you guys have shared. I hope I have shared as much as information what I know. So that can be wrong as well. You guys can correct me. You guys can share your feedback in the comment section. What I would say is like, do not take blindly my view. It is just for educational purpose. So try to analyze from your end as well and try to analyze from yourself and try to take some small entries and risk yourself and see how the charts or how the market is playing around. Clear? So any queries, do let me know in the comment section. Also, any corrections, do let me know in the comment section. I would be happy to help you guys. Thanks a lot, Chetan, for moving.